everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another Friday Focus video. Today I'm focusing on decorating envelopes. This is the very first video in a new mini series, all featuring envelopes and how to decorate them. So to be honest, I don't decorate my envelopes too often, just every once in a while when I feel like doing something a little bit different. But I thought it'd be kind of fun to show some ideas on how you can do that. And for this very first video, I thought it would be beneficial to show you guys the We Are Memory Keepers envelope punch board. You can make your own envelopes using this punch board. And this is my most favorite solution for making an envelope. And I've said in the past, I just don't make envelopes. I just don't want to deal with it, which is true. But for these kind of specialized decorative envelopes, I think having a pattern paper or something on the envelope just makes it even that much more special. So in that case, I would make my own envelope, and this is the way I would do it if I was to make my own envelope all the time. So this is the envelope punch board. I'm going to show you a little bit about it and then walk you through an envelope, and then we'll get to the decorating. All of the directions are up here on the board if you ever need any more instruction, or if it's been a while since you made an envelope, you can always come up here to the directions. So the part that's kind of cool is that they have the measurements all on the board. I'm going to zoom in so you can see them. So it tells you if your card is this size, this is the paper size of that you'll cut to make the envelope, and then this is the score line. You'll only use the score line measurement once, and I'll show you that in a minute here. So for the card I'm going to be making an envelope for today, which is this card, it's my card from this week's Color Wednesday video. I'm going to make an envelope for this card. I'm looking for a 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, and the closest size they have is 4 1/2 by 5 1/2, and they say that's A2. I think they're not saying that that's the size of an A2 card. They're saying that that's the closest measurement, and if you wanted to make an envelope for an A2 card, that's the size you would work with. It's just slightly larger, a little more wide. It's 4 1/2 instead of 4 1/4. So for that size of card, I would cut out some pattern paper that is 8 1/8 inch by 8 1/8 inch, and then I would score at 3 3/4. So I'm going to zoom out again. So I've cut my pattern paper to the size it needs to be, and we're only going to use this scoring measurement of 3 3/4 once, and it's just the very first time you put it in the board. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to line up this edge with 3 3/4, and I'll punch, and then I'm also going to score right here. It does come with like a scoring tool right here that you can pull out, but I don't like that one as much, so I'm going to use my Teflon bone folder that I always use with my scoring board. And I'll just score that. And I'm going to turn it, and I'm going to line up that score line. I don't know if you guys can see it on this pattern paper, but I'm lining up my score line with this little point on this punch here, this little point. So I'll punch again, and then scoring up from this bottom corner. I'll turn it again, line up my score line with that little point, punch, and then score from that bottom corner. And last time, line up my score line with that point, punch, and score from the bottom right. All right, so you can go ahead and fold your envelope like this if you want, but I want to have rounded flaps. So I'm going to turn my punch board, my envelope punch board, and I can punch from this side, and that just rounds the edge right there. One more. All right, so now I have the basic shape for my envelope and all the scoring lines. So I can start to fold my flaps in. All right, and I have a pretty pattern on the inside. I'm gonna go ahead and flatten out these sides with my bone folder. And if you notice when you bring this up, that this flap's gonna overhang just a little bit. So I'm gonna add adhesive, and I'm just gonna kind of miss the very point. I'll come right up here, and I've made my envelope super fast and easy. That took me 5 minutes, but I was explaining, and I think the first minute I was just talking at you. So super fast. I'm going to go ahead and go into decorating the envelope right now. I've pre-cut some special paper here. This paper right here is actually label paper. It was from a full 8.5 by 11 piece of label paper. If you have anything like this at home, go ahead and use it. But if not, you can just use a thinner cardstock, maybe like a computer paper or type paper. You just want something super thin that's not gonna add a whole lot of bulk to your card. And if you don't have it as a label, you can add adhesive to the back later. In my case, mine's a label and it is cut to 6 inches wide by 2 1/4 tall. And I'm gonna get my scoring board here and I'm just gonna score at 1 1/4. And this is going to be on the envelope and then it's going to wrap around the corner. So I'm just scoring that so I know exactly where it's gonna fold. All right, now I have some masking paper and this masking paper is cut to 3 inches wide by, let me check for you, 1 3/4 tall. So 3 inches wide, 1 3/4 tall. And before I peel that off, I'm gonna round the corners with my We Are Member Keepers Corner Chomper with the 1/4 inch rounder. I'm just gonna round these corners. It's gonna give it more of a finished edge. And I'll go ahead and peel the backing off this. All right, and I'm gonna try to get this. So the scoring line's right here. I'm just coming to this side because I'm right-handed and it's a little easier to get this centered. Just putting that mask on there, kind of centered into that corner. Just like that. I'm taking another piece of masking paper and this is cut to 2 1/4 tall by 1 1/4 wide. It's basically the size so that it covers up that flap that's folded over the edge of the envelope. If you want, you could also just use a post-it note for this since it is just hanging off the edge. All right, and now we're gonna do a bunch of stamping and also some blending. So I'm getting my craft mat. And the first stamp set I'm using is from Simon Says Stamp. This is the Cupcake Party stamp set. I'm gonna use this long border stamp. I'm using Stampin' Up! Ink in Crumb Cake. Just gonna do a couple stripes. All right, now I have an ink blending tool and I'm just gonna pick some of that ink up. I'm gonna start really lightly off the edge and start to bring in some color. These blending techniques tend to work better with distress inks, but I really wanted to use this color of ink. All right, and that's all I'm going to need for this ink for now. So I'm gonna get rid of my craft mat here and I'm gonna peel up my masking paper. If you want, you can put this back on the backing sheet for another envelope label. All right, I'm using another Simon Says Stamp stamp set. This is Envelope Sentiments. First, starting with the line of hearts, I'm going to be using Hero Arts Pale Tomato ink. And I'm just gonna put those hearts at the very bottom of this section. Those little hearts right there. Then I'm going back to Crumb Cake ink and I'm going to be doing the 4 lines that are in the Envelope Sentiment stamp set. Really light lines. And then the Happy Mail 4 stamp. And I'll do the Open Me ASAP on the flap. And then those lines again, I'm just gonna turn it and I'm going to have the lines coming off the end here. And there's a little itty bitty From stamp in that stamp set. And I'm going to put that right there. All right, so there's my label. I think the last thing I wanna do is I'm just going to round these 2 corners. So once again, I'll just get my 1/4 inch rounder. All right, here's my envelope with the flap right there. And I'm going to peel up my label sticker. And I'll put this right down at the bottom. Then I can wrap this around that edge. It's so close that right there. I can fill out my address right there. And then there's the front. I think it goes super cute with the card. Kind of very retro, and it's got that retro pattern on the inside. So when I'm ready to send this to the recipient, I'm going to go ahead and put a lot of glue right up here, because I want to make sure that flap stays well closed while it goes to the mail. Make sure you put your stamp up there and fill out the address, and you're good to go. All right, I decided I wanted to add one last thing, and it's the bow stamp from that Envelope Sentiment stamp set. So this is, since the label is already on there, I'm going to take two Post-its, and I'm just blocking off the top and bottom of the envelope. Obviously, if you guys do a similar design, you'd want to do this before you put the label on. But hindsight is 20/20, as they say, right? Just inking up that stamp. And I'll just bring this in right here. There we go, all finished. There's the front. And here is the back with the card peeking out. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you like this video and want to see more, go ahead and hit a thumbs up and subscribe. And thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys next time.